Starting tonight with a world exclusive in our backyard. What environmentalists warn is a Pacific disaster. What regional security experts are calling a major concern. These are the waters of one of the world's largest marine reserves, the Phoenix Island Protected Area, or PIPA, a World Heritage crown jewel. But now One News has discovered its gatekeeper, the Republic of Kiribati, is unlocking it, and some fear they're handing China the key. The location of this is critical. We're over central Kiribati now. This is the protected area, just over 400,000 square kilometres. And up there, a focus on Canton Island, a former US territory and Air Force base right next to American waters. If China sets up there, it gains not just a major military foothold in the region, but also control over vast and vital shipping lanes to the north. Here's our Pacific correspondent, Barbara Drever, with exclusive details.
One of the largest protected areas on Earth, but not for long.
It's going to cause a lot of ripples all around the world.
One News has obtained secret documents showing the Kiribati government is planning to open the marine reserve to commercial fishing. Cabinet has also decided to delist PIPA as a World Heritage Site. Devastating news for former President Anote Tong, who was instrumental in setting it up.
It's a huge blow to conservation in general, but I think it's a much bigger blow to our credibility as a nation.
The Kiribati government claims the reason for the radical move is so it can make $200 million a year in tuna fishing licenses. Critics question that financial forecast and say it's more valuable as a marine reserve.
The ability for people to have any confidence in working with Kiribati like this in the future is going to be really diminished. And that's a real shame, because I think there are very important partnerships that can be developed with Kiribati that have PIPA as the centerpiece.
There's deep suspicion this has all been driven by China. In a shock move 2 years ago, Kiribati ditched its 23-year allegiance to Taiwan, instead signing up to China and the promise of a $66 million grant. PIPA is attractive to China, not only for its fishing wealth, but its strategically significant location, spanning 400,000 kilometres of ocean near islands with US military installations.
Kiribati obviously has real strategic value to China, if it could potentially develop some strategic infrastructure on Canton Island, which had both commercial fisheries usage, but also potential military usage as well.
China's already provided funding to help develop Canton Island, including upgrading an airstrip on the island. President Tanis Mamal has denied it will be used for military purposes, but it's feared China is gaining a tight grip on the financially vulnerable island nation. Kiribati has also signalled its intention to leave the Pacific Islands Forum, where leaders work and stand together for the good of the region.
Well, it simply means that China will have more and more foothold, and the more isolated Kiribati becomes, the more they play straight into China's hands.
There's hope the Kiribati cabinet will do a last-minute U-turn, but there's no doubt there's stormy seas ahead.
And Barbara's with us now. Cabinet's already made its decision. Realistically, what hope is there that it can be reversed?
Look, there's an almighty battle going on as I speak, and that's between the PIPA board, also donors, and the environment minister himself, who says he wasn't consulted even. So he submitted this 20-page document to Cabinet. They'll be discussing that in the next couple of days and hopefully make a decision. But what that decision is, it's unlikely to change their position. And if that happens, then they'll have to go to Parliament, they have to repeal their own PIPA domestic law, and even to deregister from the World Heritage Site is going to take some doing. This is such an important issue, like both security-wise and also conservation-wise, and for the environment. So people are just hoping that the right decision is finally made.
Kia ora, Barb. Pacific correspondent Barbara Drever, thank you very much.